I am on a quest that involves ice class expedition yachts.
Surrounded by snow.
In the last 6 months, I've been to Finland, Norway, Louisiana, and Florida looking at prospective vessels for conversion into ice class expedition yachts. Expedition yacht captain and designer Grant Mohn and I inspected one vessel that really stood out from the pack in terms of the mission capabilities that were built into this hull already. So looking at these specs more closely, we wanted real ice class. So ice class C means you can go through a meter of ice. A lot of expedition yachts are really only qualified to go through what I call cocktail ice, chipped ice. Twin turbine, a large helicopter can go on this heli deck and also into the hangar, and it's certified, meaning that you can refuel, and it's got all the firefighting requirements that you're going to need for class and insurance. A European build, this vessel is built at Ulstein in Norway and designed by Ulstein, so it's got a terrific pedigree in that regard. It can go 15 plus knots with Bergen engines, Rolls-Royce engines, and it's got 3,000 gross tons approximately, so there's plenty of room for guests. You can either go with 12 big suites or you could go up to 36 guests, no problem in this hull. It's got ocean crossing range with plenty of fuel left over once you get there. And that's another shortfall of some of these vessels, that you can cross an ocean and then you're out of fuel. And it's got at least 30 days endurance, so you don't need to be at a dock or any sort of refueling facility for more than 30 days. And that also speaks to the capability of handling trash and waste management. And so that's important. You'll have to excuse the design. This is not Grant's design. This is just me roughing out the spaces on the existing hull. Has a forward all-glass observation lounge for guests. It's got a giant glass lounge back here, sort of like bold. It's got a huge amount of tender and toy space. Back here, there's the beach club and the spa with a side opening. Lots of sun deck space, swimming pools, gyms, whatever you want to put on the deck. It can all be there, and Grant can design it so that it actually looks attractive, unlike my designs. So this is the ugly duckling that needs to become a swan. It's 78 meters long, 255 feet, with a big beam of 17 meters or 55 feet. Ulstein built four of these seismic vessels in a series at their shipyard in Norway. Grant and I went aboard this one in Florida, where it is laid up. Seismic vessels tow an array of air guns and audio receivers, hydrophones, behind them. These powerful air guns fire loud blasts of compressed air every 10 to 15 seconds, and the sound waves produced penetrate deep into the seabed, and they bounce back to the surface. Their mission takes them into all oceans in all weather conditions globally, with reliable systems and redundancies. The forward area on this vessel is impressive, and we're going to explore that in some detail. But first, let's look at the incredible machinery and deck space that we are going to carve out and repurpose in order to make this into an extraordinary expedition vessel. Two huge decks between the helideck and the main deck. Here you can see these hydraulically driven drums that would have a bunch of wire cable on the to tow the arrays behind the vessel. So this deck here is probably got a height of about 18 feet, I would say, and is just crammed with these drums and all the hydraulic equipment that supports them. And this will all come out and be very welcome for a scrapper. The next deck down is the main deck, and this is an extraordinary space. It is actually 8,000 square feet of fairly open space to work with here. So walking forward here, these beams, of course, are going to come out for the scrapper. This becomes our tinder and toys garage right here. We'll pull those drums out at the forward end and clean out other things that we don't need, and we're going to have a nice big tenders and toys garage there with plenty of deck space above it that we can repurpose. And now you can see how this vessel takes shape. The helideck was upgraded on this vessel to accommodate a AS-332 Super Puma, which has an empty weight of 10,000 pounds and is over 60 feet long. Given this vessel's beam, there's no reason that you couldn't hangar two helicopters underneath this enlarged platform. So let's go inside the hull now, starting on the bridge deck. It's quite an enormous bridge. It extends back 40 feet in the hull, and it has all of the electronics and radio gear that you would expect in a global commercial vessel with this mission. 360 degrees of glass, large wing stations with tremendous visibility, both fore and aft, and of course, alarm systems, monitoring every aspect of the ship's operation. Going down half a deck and aft from the bridge, there's an interesting little cluster here of a conference room and the ship's hospital, and it sits out on the deck. It's open deck, so this could be repurposed as some sort of a sky lounge or an on-deck gym facility, or just taken off. Going further aft and a little bit below to the tween deck under the heli deck is a spacious recording room for all the seismic equipment, with offices and atmospherically controlled racks for all these servers to record the data, interpret the data. And this space would most likely be torn out. Returning forward to the deck just under the bridge deck, which is the B deck, 32 crew members, including a big suite for the captain and a matching suite for the chief engineer. There's plenty of headroom in these spaces. There's ducting for air conditioning. There's a lot of plumbing. So typically what we would do is knock these units together, put in the big windows, maybe some decks on the exterior, and use these as guest accommodations, including a very large owner suite and the forward observation lounge. Going down a deck to A deck, you're still one deck above the main deck. Here you've got your galley, your mess room for the crew, day room for the crew, walk-in refrigerator and freezers, extra cabins for heli pilots and special crew members, and a crew cinema. And this will connect directly to the large glass enclosed lounge, a formal dining area, and also provide access for the crew to the on-deck dining areas. Again, we'll keep the main deck pretty much the way that it is already, with crew cabins and facilities and laundry for the ship. The lowest deck is pretty much all engine room. Here is the engineer's control room, monitoring the main Bergen Rolls-Royce diesel main engines and three Caterpillar generators in a vast engine room. The mains are fitted with PTOs, or power takeoff systems, that deliver electricity to the system when the ship is underway, creating more efficiency and reducing emissions. The slow-turning props reduce vibration and noise while underway. This vessel was built for seismic research. All the machinery installations are resiliently mounted. This means that noise and vibration probably surpass the standards of most yachts. Because of the extraordinary design and capabilities built into this vessel already, the conversion is going to be fairly straightforward, and the resulting global expedition yacht will be ready to meet the challenges of cruising safely and comfortably in all oceans.